Welcome to this wonderful occasion. The Lord blesses you with great kindness. He loves you from within. He has created you both. He now welcomes you to this holy sacrament to which you are the participants within it. You are the ones who are giving yourselves to each other. But not only that, but that also to God. I welcome you to St. Francis of the Tejas Catholic Church. It is an honor for me to be a witness to your marriage. May the Lord bless you and keep you always. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves to celebrate this mystery. Let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. Father, hear the prayers for Jorge and April, who today are united in marriage before your altar. Give them your blessings and strengthen their love for each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity with the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. We have our first person to do a reading.
Thank you. letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more exciting way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, and a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy, and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous. It is not inflated, it is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, kingdom and glory.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, kingdom and glory.
Everyone who loves is begotten of God and knows God. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, kingdom and glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, from the beginning of creation, God made male and female. For this reason, man shall leave his father and his mother and be joined to his wife. And the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I have a 16-page dissertation to give now. I did promise you 4 hours. I whittled it a little bit. There was a story once about a priest, a young man who happened to do his first wedding. And as he was going up with the rehearsal that Sunday, for the wedding was on the Monday, he was trying to explain to the women who were trying to do things the way they wanted, and he wanted to do the way he wanted it, and there was a lot of strife. But after a while, everything went well. And later on at the reception on the Monday afterwards, a little lady was asking him, she said, you know, I wonder, what does he know about weddings? If I knew as little as he does, she says, we'd be in right trouble. But that's not really true, is it? Most of us live in families. We know our mothers and fathers. We have been with them. We have grown up with them. We have seen what marriage is from the inside out. But that is a good question. What is marriage? What is it supposed to be? It is something that is given to us, a gift that God has given us so that we may become one in His unity. It is a relationship that is taken by God and given to us so that we may be able to participate in His loving creation. That's what marriage is. That's what the natural law to which we are a party to. We become Christ-like in that unity. That's why the church celebrates it in such a wonderful way. Because it is that sacredness of what it is in Christ. Paul Teacher says, God is love. That love is the power that drives everything towards everything else that is. When a man and a woman live in unity of consciousness, their individualities disappear, and they themselves become part of their own bodies. Coming together in union, not just in a physical manner, but also in the union which is through the sacrament of marriage, is the revelation of a deeper and spiritual meaning. Marriage symbolizes that unity, that consciousness, that being. And it's not just a new beginning for you. It's a whole change of life. You too, Jorge, April, you are going to have to be an example to many others in this world of how to live in unity with each other and also in unity with the world. But not just in the physical life, but also in that of the spiritual sense. Your faith has to be kept alive within your hearts. This is what the husband, by the way, is supposed to do. He is charged with keeping his wife's faith and faithfulness. By the way, the wife has to do the same. Both of you have to respect each other's faith. Both of you have to come together in that unity and practice your faith so that your children, God willing, that they too will see that in that faith that they will be able to come to Jesus Christ as well. You are the ones who begin that process. And that has to work with good communication, constantly. And of course, I'm not just talking to the two of you. I'm talking to the rest of us. As we hear, and I see a lovely group of people before me, you think you're getting off light. You're not. This is what the community is about. The community of saints, the community of the church, is here to help this couple make the right decisions in their life. And if they need help, that we are there to help them, to give them our support, our understanding, and our love. Some people say, you know, she's now gone. He got rid of her. Hey, bye-bye, this is his problem. We can change the room, you know, make it into an office or a den or something to that effect. You know, she's gone, bye. Wrong, you have gained a son. And by doing so, you are responsible for their care. Same thing with Jorge's parents. You know, you're not left just the house like. He's now married to another woman. Oh, no longer there. Great, no problem. Make it a tea room out of it. No, it's not going to work. You've gained a daughter. And your duty is to help them grow together. Give them the example that they need for their marriage. And as for all the people who are here with them, the bridesmaids and the best man, You know, your duty is also, because you have been chosen by them, to be there for them in times of trouble. And believe you me, you will have troubles, whether they're small or large. Your duty as friends is to support them. Give them your support. Not just in the sense of a physical way, but also in that of a spiritual way. Pray for this couple. Use the ability of your faith to call upon God's blessings so that He may also protect them in this life. I am honored to be here today as a witness to your faith, as the preacher who preaches at you, looking down at you from the high step, and can waggle my finger at you. I'm also here to help you. If you ever have a problem, ever need some counseling or friendship, you can always call on me. That's my duty. That's the duty of the father of the community. So don't ever be afraid to actually look for help. To be able to look for help is a sign of humility. And in that humility is the sign of your love. And in that love for each other, that which holds you together, that's the bond that you are now going into. The vows that you will make are actually all about love. Nothing more, nothing less. And you are giving yourselves to each other. But you're also giving yourselves to God. There was a poem. Now, I like poetry. I can't really... I seem to be missing a piece of it, but that's all right. It's nothing unusual. The piece I want to say is in the first couple of verses anyway. It was written by a man by the name of Phil Coulter, an Irishman, of course, naturally enough, and it's called Perfect Harmony. You have exchanged solemn vows before God. You have made the sacred promise to one another to love, honor, cherish, and to share the years ahead. You have joined together, but you are still individuals. Stay very close, but allow each other room to breathe. You have made the commitment for the long road ahead. Now you must learn to be good traveling companions. Walk with dignity. Walk with God. Stand shoulder to shoulder and take strength in your togetherness. Walk hand in hand and take pride in your closeness. Be open, be honest, but respect each other's privacy. Be caring and attentive, but respect each other's space. Never forget that you belong together as part of God's natural law, just as the waves belong to the ocean and the stars in the skies. May the Lord bless you. May you grow old together. And may your offspring be bountiful and gracious. Amen. I would like the two of you to stand, please. Move those chairs, thank you. a little short. I don't bite. My dear friends, we are gathered here in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the place of this church's minister and its community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism and now enriches you and strengthens you with a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of this church, I ask you to state your intentions.
Okay.
Good. Jorge, April, you have come freely and without reservation. You have given yourselves to each other in marriage. Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up in accordance to the law of the church?
I do.
Since you have your intentions and have consented to enter into this marriage, will you turn and join your hands? Ready? I'm gonna have to stand in between them here. Oh, look. I, Jorge. Take you, April. For my lawful wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better. For worse. For richer. For poorer. In sickness. And in health. Until death does us part. Ready?
Yes.
I, April. Take you, Jorge. For my lawful husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better. For worse. For richer. For poorer. In sickness and in health. Until death does us part. Lord, bless and consecrate Jorge and April in their love for each other. May these rings be the symbol of the true faith for each other and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. April, take this ring As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Put it on her.
Put it on her.
Repeat after me. Jorge, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Everybody stand, please. We come before our Father in heaven, and we ask him for to bless this marriage and to send forth his spirit of love upon him. And so now we have our general intercessions. In the sacrament of marriage. May your fullness of blessings come upon them as husband and wife, so that they may come together rejoicing in the gift of love, that they may be enriched by your church's teachings and also by their family and children to come. Lord, may they both praise you with a great happiness and turn their lives into a blissful love. May they also be glad that they may help to work together, to know their fate, to keep each other strong in their times of need. May they pray to you in their community with their church, and may they be witnesses in the world to your gracious gift. May they also reach old age in the company of their friends and come to the lasting kingdom of God. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may kiss your bride. Lord bless you and keep you. May he send forth all his blessings upon you. And may the Lord give you the grace in this world to witness to him and to yourselves. May the Lord bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. You are husband and wife. God bless you both.
Thank you.